Okay, then I will go to the next slide that is deleting a node in a linked list. So there are three cases, right, for this deletion, right? You want, if you want to delete the first node, if you want to delete the last node, and if you want to delete the node after a given node, how can we do? Okay, so the first case is we want to delete the first node from the linked list. So, okay, so in this case, we have this one, we want to delete this node, right? So it's very easy, right? So in order to delete the first node, so you, because you have a pointer start, right? So you can just simply change the value of start to the current position dot next. Right, so now start is point to one, right? So the new start would be what? Would be 7, right? So it should be, what is a 7? The 7 is start dot next. So this is what we can do, right? So this is the same as set start is equal to start dot next, and then three pointer. Free current pointer. So we because we keep the start pointer, that is the one. Why do we have to use this function free? Because if we forget to remove or to free memory for pointer, right? So if you want to reallocate, or if you want to use that free, seem to be free, right, pointer, but you didn't free it before, so you cannot use it anymore. Okay, so you need to do garbage collection. Garbage collection is the term that we can use, that we can use for freeing the memory. If you don't want this location, you want to free it. So you can just simply use free pointer. In C programming, you can use free and pointer like this, free pointer. Okay. Okay, this is a way that you want to delete the first node from the linked list. And the next one, that is the, if you want to delete the last node, where is the last node? The last node is this. Mm-hmm. So what you have to do is you can just simply traverse until you go to the correct position. But in this way, right, if you go to the current position, which is so the position that we want to delete, right? But we don't have the pre-pointer. This one is pointer. This one is, the green one is pre-pointer, right? If we just only use pointer, right, when we delete, so we cannot go back or set up the pre-pointer or the this one. Because if you want to delete the last node, right, what you have to do is you have to change the link node of 6 to be now. You have to set this to be now, right? So this loop will continually traverse until the pointer to next is not equal is equal to now. Okay, if the pointer is equal to now, then the pointer stop, but the pointer here, you cannot go back to change the value of 6 node, the node 6. So this is why we have to keep track with two pointer. The first one is pre-pointer. Pre-pointer means the previous pointer, right? Previous pointer. And pointer is a current position, current pointer. And then once we find a given value of 5, right? We will use pre-pointer and set pre-pointer dot next to be now. Pre-pointer dot next set to be now, set to be now, right? Right, set to be now. Okay. So and that's all. And then you have to free pointer as well. Free pointer, so it means this one, you have to free this one, this node. And the operating system can use this location. Okay, so the next one is a bit complicated. Okay. No, if you want to delete a node after a given node, for this example, you want to delete a node. Which node? The node number two, right? If you want to delete this node, what shall we do? It's really easy, right? What we have to do is you have to use this pointer and then point to here, right? What can we do? How can we do? So first of all, we have to traverse along this link list first to find node 2, right? With the pointer and the previous pointer that is 4, right? Okay, so what we have to do is you have to, the node 4, right? You have to link to the node pointer 6. 6 is PTR next. Am I right? 6 is PTR next. So P pointer dot next. Ppointer.next will be stored by the pointer next. Pointer next. Okay, once again. Suppose we go to the correct position, the right position here, right? With PTR. And then this is previous pointer, right? What you want to do is you have to this one. 6, because this one is PTR, so 6 is PTR next, right? 6 is PTR next, but what we want to do is we want to delete 2, so we want to point 4 to 6. So pre-pointer next, will be assigned to PTR next, and then free temp, where temp is a pointer. You want to free this to delete node 2 from the linked list. Okay, this is a way that we are going to delete the node from a given node. Okay. Do you have any question? Okay. So I will go to the. Okay. So this slide. I will ask you all to, because there is a program, C program that provided in the lecture note, right? In this chapter that I have already put it in LEB 2, or I gave you in the line group. Okay, so if you want to try by yourself, you can write a program in order to create the linked list and perform insertion, deletion of all cases, right? Mm-hmm. And if you cannot right now, What I suggest is that you can just simply copy this source code from the lecture note, and then you from the book, and then try to compile and try to understand it. Okay. The C program will be exactly the same or similar to the algorithm that I have already talked about today. Okay, so we can the C program can just simply change from this algorithm into the what we call the C program like this. Okay, so this one I will not I will not go into detail to explain about the C programming. I just want you to try to copy, and then maybe you can copy function one after another, one function after another, and then you can try to maybe you can start from insertion, right? And then try to print out, because we have create linked list, display linked list, and insert new linked list, right? You can try to combine your program, right, gradually, and then you can see what is going on in this program. Okay, I'm not sure about the page, so you can go through and have a look. Okay, this is for the linked list. And after that, there are many kinds of linked list, like the type of the linked list. The next one will be the circular linked list. What does it mean by circular linked list? When we talk about the circular linked list, it's a linked list, but the last node will contain the pointer instead of, normally the linked list itself is will end up with now pointer. Okay, now pointer, but for the circular linked list, it will, instead of being now here, it will point back to the start node or the first node. So that's why we call this one is a singular linked list or singly linked list, right? While traversing circular linked list, we can begin at any node and traverse a list in any direction, okay? Forward or backward until we reach to the same node we started. Therefore, a circular linked list has no beginning and no end, okay? So that's why we call circular linked list, right? It's an extension of the linked list, the simple linked list. So this is an example of how to show the singular linked list in the memory representation. From the left hand side, like you can see the singular linked list starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 7 will go back to 1, right? So in this case, in the memory representation on the right hand side, so you can see that H here point to 4, and E right point to 7, and 7, 8.2 here, and then 10.2, 10, right? And then 1 point back to 1, right? So this one we call this one is a circular linked list, because we have no now pointer, right? Now pointer. There is no now pointer for the circular linked list. What do you think? Where or when we will use circular linked list? We can use circular linked list to represent Q. Okay. Can you remember? Suppose you have a Q, right? Maybe you are the owner of the noodle restaurant, right? Maybe you have 100 cards, because maybe your restaurant is very famous, right? So you have the 100 cards, right, to give to the customer, right? And then once you have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 99, that's okay. And 100, right, you have to reuse, right, 0, 1 again, and 0, 2. Okay, this is a way that we are going to use the circular link list in order to represent the queue. Okay, do you get my point? Okay, for circular link list, right, we also have insertion, deletion as well, right? For insertion, we have insert new node at the beginning and new node at the end, right? And this one is the example algorithms for inserting a node at the beginning and at the end, right? I'm not going to explain you into detail, but I just want to briefly scan through this one and explain to you a bit about the type of the operations can be done or can be performed onto the circular link list. And deletion will be the first node and last node to be deleted. Okay. First node and the last node. Okay. We can have a look. And then also we also have a C program to represent the circular link list in the lecture note in the book chapter as well. And then the next one, this one is important, it's quite important because we have the singly link list, right? And we also have doubly link list. I like this one. I don't know why. When I was studying in the university, right? I like the word doubly link list. Link list is too short, right? But doubly link list means, right, you have go in any direction, right? As it then, right, when you talk about a doubly link list, like it is a two-way link list. It's a bit more complex of the link list because it will contain the pointer to the next node and the previous node, right? As you can see from the previous slide, right, I have already talked about the singly link list when you want to insert a pointer in between, insert a new node in between the link list, right? You have to keep track on the previous and the, how can I say, the next node, right? So it might be easier if you can have the doubly link list in order to keep track this, right? So the doubly link list will contain three parts: data, pointer to the next, and pointer to the previous node. Okay, it can be shown like this, right? So the first one, 1.22, and previous 2.21, right? When we use this one in order to make it easier to understand, that is a doubly link list. Doubly or double means two, right? So you can see that for the doubly link list, right? The first node, the previous node or the first node will be now. And the next node of the last node will be now as well. This is end node. This is the first node or beginning node. Okay, set to be now. And if you want to implement it in C program, you can just simply add up one more fields. That is a stuck node previous. Don't forget to put asterisk sign here. Asterisk sign here to make this variable previous and next to be the link or a link to the structure node. Link to structure node. Yeah, these two links, the previous and next. Okay, this is the way that we will show you the memory representation of a doubly linked list, right? So in the doubly linked list, we have three fields, right? In order to implement this doubly linked list, the previous field and the next field, right? So for the first field, right, the previous node will be now, will set to now. And similarly, for the last node, will be set next to now as well. Okay, this we call the bleeding list of hello. And if you want to delete, or if you want to insert new node to the bleeding list, you can do similar things like in for the linked list, right? You have to insert at the beginning, at the end, after a given node, and before a given node, right? In order to insert to the beginning, right? You can do similarly, right? First of all, you have to set up new node first, and then set new node to where you, and you have known that for the first node, right? The previous node you set to now, okay, you set now first, and then the new node point to next, will point to start, and that's all. That's all? Is that all? No, it's not, because it is a double link list, like you have to keep track on the start node as well, the previous start node, right? Start previous will point back to new node. Point back to new node is mean this. And start is equal to new node. Start is equal to new node. Change the position of the start to new node. And that's all. Okay. I think this one is straightforward. So I will go to the next one. That is inserting new node at the end. You can do similar things like in for the inserting node at the beginning. Okay. And then inserting after a given node. After a given node, is 3, right? Algorithm is similar to the case of linked list, but you have to keep track for two links, so it might be longer piece of code, and before given node, okay? And for deleting, right, for deletion, we have also four cases as well. First node, last node to be deleted, and the node after given node is deleted, and the node before given node is deleted. Okay, you can have a look to the program into detail, right? There is also a program example program in the book chapter. Now we have reached to the most complicated linked list that we call the circular double linked list. We also have the circular linked list. We also have double linked list, but circular double linked list or CDLL is a combination of the advantages or the disadvantages of the two things, right? If you contain a pointer to the next as well as the pointer to the previous node. And also we have the circular direction. So instead of putting now into the first and the last node, right? You have to put the direction back and forth, right? For the first node will point to the last node, and the last node will point to the first node as well. No, I'm sorry. Only okay, I am right already. I've said that the last node will point to the first node, and the first node will point to the last node as well. I am right. Okay, this is what we call the circular double linked list. And in order to set up the operations of the circular double linked list, right, we also have the insertion for the beginning and end. And delete the node, right? Delete the first node and the last node. Okay, that's all the four kinds of the linked list that I would like to talk to you today. But you can see that we also have a special pointer that we call start, right? And the pointer start, we can call the header link list. A header link list is a special type of the link list which contains a header node at the beginning of the list, because we want to define the header or the starting points of the link list, any link list, right? So you need to find, you need to declare or allocate a memory address in order to keep track on the pointer. So in the header link list, start will not point to the first node of the list, but start will contain the address of the header node. Contain the address of the header node, right? And we have two variants of header link list, right? Ground header link list is stored now to the next field of the last node. And circular header link list will store the address of the header node in the next field of the last node. Okay, this is an example of the two variants of the header link list. The first one is the ground header link list, right? So the header node, this is a special or the dummy node. Please, we cannot call dummy node, but it's called header node, right? This is a special node that points to the first node, right? This is the ground one. And for the case of the circular, right, the header node will point to the first one as well. And then the last node will point to this header node as well. So why do we have to make use of the header node? Because sometimes you need to keep track in the program, right? You cannot keep track on each address of your node in the linked list. You need to keep the position, the current position, or the previous position, right, into a special variables, pointer variables. So you need the header node. Actually, simply speaking, header node is just another variable or pointer variables to keep track on the location of the linked list. What's that? Okay, this is a header linked list. Okay, this is the way to traverse along the circular header link list. Okay, it's similar to the previous slide. Okay, here we are to the last topic today. That is how can we make use of the link list or many kinds of link lists. For example, if you want to represent metrics, right? I'm not sure whether this, okay, not yet. You have not yet study about the calculus tree, right? When you are trying to study about the calculus tree, you may have to deal with the matrix. Sometimes the matrix can be represented in terms of the matrix or the sparse matrix. But if you want to make it more flexible, right, you may have to use or represent it in terms of the linked list. Okay, here we are. On the right hand side, it is the metric. It is the linked list representation of the left hand side metric, right? Okay, this is okay. Normally, when you talk about the linked list, you will think about it as the vector or the one dimensional matrix. But you have never known that the two dimensional matrix can be also represented in terms of the linked list as well. It will be more complicated, okay? Mm-hmm. But in this chapter, right, we can just simply think about the just only one dimensional matrix or the only one dimensional linked list, okay? And the last one that I will talk today is the application of the linked list, right? Then, okay. This is the polynomial representation. Normally, when you deal with in C programming, right, you want to maybe you can deal with the integer or floating point, right? Floating point will represent real number, right? And you can also represent complex number. That's not the problem. You can keep it in terms of the data structure of the real number and imaginary number. That's not the problem. But if you want to represent polynomial, what can we do? Considering a polynomial 6x raised to the power 3 plus 3x or 9x squared plus 7x plus 1. How can we represent it in terms of C programming? So sometimes we have to separate it into two parts, right? Coefficient part and power part, right? Here, 6, 9, 7, 1 are the coefficients of the term, and 3, 2, 1, 0 will be the power respectively. So in terms of polynomial, and you, if you want to deal with the polynomial, you may have to use the linked list representation in terms of polynomial. For example, you can have a node, right? 6 will be coefficient, 3 will be the power of the first term. This term is 6x less to the power 3. This one is 9 less to the 9 square. And this one is 7x, and the last one will be 1, right? Plus, plus, plus. Okay, this is an example of how to make use of the linked list, right? Just in the application of polynomial representation. Okay, so here we are at the last page of this. So I have homework for you, right? The first one is go to write a program for all operation of linked list. The code is provided in the book chapter already, right? So actually you can just copy it and try to compile. But what you have to do is you have to try to understand and write. You have to be able to write it. If I ask you to write the inserting an element to the linked list, so you have to do. You can be able to do. And second one, because we have known about the polynomial, right? Okay, try to write a program of the polynomial representation as well. This one is also in the book chapter as well. Okay, so you can write these two programs, and then I will. Okay, if you finish, you can just keep them to you, right? And then the third one is try to do the exercises at the end of the chapter. Okay, this one is important. Okay, every items are important. Okay. Okay, that's all for today's class.